Hey everyone, this is Grace from Kapwing, and I think I found my new favorite video editing trend. Creators have been using green screen technology to create videos like this, where they show two versions of themselves, where it looks like one version is seen through a portal. Many of the people that have been doing this trend have been posting their videos on TikTok and using the Not Your Barbie Girl song by Ava Max on top of the video, but this is just a super cool video editing technique in general and will work with any sound you want. And the best part is you don't need any fancy equipment to do this. In this tutorial, I'll show you exactly how this works, how to do it yourself, and I'll give you tips along the way that I've gained through experience. Make sure to hit that subscribe button to become part of our awesome community of modern creators, and now let's get started. So you're probably wondering how this video editing technique works, and essentially it's using chroma key, also known as green screen technology, where you film videos and then you take a specific color out of the video to reveal the video behind it. So to create one of these videos, you'll film two clips. The first one, you're going to be holding an object that will act as your green screen, although it doesn't have to be green. Then you'll film one without that object, which is the video that will be behind it. Then you'll combine both of those clips in Kapwing, which is our online editor that allows you to do chroma key techniques and remove colors from videos. So with that in mind, the first step is to film your first clip. And this clip will be the foreground, and you want to be holding your object that will act as your green screen. Then you'll move it around the screen in the pattern that you want the background video to be shown in. And what object you use and how you film this video will determine how smooth the end product video looks. So you want to put a lot of thought into this step. I have two major tips for this step. The first one is that when you move your object around, you want to make sure you're doing it slowly. The faster it is, the harder it will be for the editor to just pick out that color. So slower will be better. And then the second tip is that you want to use an object that has one solid color on it and no text, and that color is unique in the frame. There's nothing else in the frame that is that color. Now, as I said earlier, this object does not have to be green, and I actually did a little experiment to figure out what kind of objects will work that are laying around the house. I tested five different objects that I had. The first one was this green folder that I've had for years. I got it at Target for like a dollar. The second one was just plain white paper. The third one was this blue laptop case. The fourth one was a piece of paper that I took a green marker and just colored all over. And then the last one was another piece of paper that I took a bluish greenish colored pencil and colored on. The best one was definitely the green folder. I think because it is pretty strong material, it wasn't flopping around, so there were no shadows on it, created a single unique color on the screen that was very different from everything else in the frame. If you have some sort of folder that is a unique color lying around, or just go buy one for pretty cheap, that's a good option. And I was also surprised that the blue colored pencil on paper was really good too. There's a couple of parts where you can see the blue, but it's pretty good for just literally taking a minute and just drawing on a piece of paper. The rest of the different materials I tried were also decent. The worst one was the white paper, which I was not surprised with because white is around in the frame a lot, so it's removing all the white in the other parts of the video, which is not desired. The blue laptop case had a white trim and a word on it, which made it harder to remove, so that wasn't the best. And then the green marker on paper probably didn't do as well as the other colored pencil one because there were streaks that made the color not even across the whole sheet. Bottom line is that if you can find an object with a single color that is pretty even across the whole surface, even if that means just taking a colored pencil and drawing all over a piece of paper, you'll be able to do this. Now, once you film that first clip, the next step is to film your second clip. So this is the clip that will go behind your first clip, and it will be the one that's kind of being revealed by the green screen. This works best if you have your filming device in the same exact position as when you filmed the first clip, so that the background will look the same and then all that's different is you. Something else you can try for this clip is to film with a filter on. Snapchat has a ton of them in addition to TikTok and some other ones. I did this with some Snapchat filters and the result does look pretty cool. And then the third step is where this all comes together. You'll be combining the clips in Kapwing and removing the color from the object to reveal the background video. So to get to Kapwing, head to the first link in the description below, and this is a template that already has the Not Your Barbie song on it. So if you don't want to use that audio, you can just delete it inside the template. So just click make it, and you're brought into the editor. So this is just a screenshot. You can just, it's a placeholder image you can just click delete on. and you'll see that this is the audio track for the song. So we can delete this later if you want, but first we're gonna start with just uploading the first clip we filmed. So click that click to upload box and find the video that you're where you're holding the object as your green screen. So once it's in the editor, make sure that it's all the way at the start of the timeline. Then we're gonna upload our second clip, which is the background scene. Once you've uploaded that second clip, click it and then scroll down all the way on the right side here and click send backwards so that that is the background clip and the clip where you have your green screen or whatever object you're gonna remove is in the front. Now, if you look at the bottom here on the timeline, you can see that these videos are not the same length. So trim them down so that they are the same length by just dragging and dropping the ends here. I'm gonna do this on both sides of the clip. You can just hit delete on these empty gaps to move them back to the start. Now this is where the magic happens. We're going to take the color that you have in the first clip and take it out of the video. To do that, click the first clip and then go to the effects tab on the right side here and click the chroma key effect. Now it automatically selects green, and if your object is sort of green, you can try changing the threshold here. As you see, I am increasing the threshold and it does remove that most of the green part of my video. Alternatively, you can choose the blue channel, which will work better if your object is kind of blue, or just choose key to color and you'll be able to take this eyedropper tool, click it, and then go to the exact color in your video, click that color, and it will select that color to remove. Now, sometimes even if you choose that color, it won't remove it. And if that happens, you can change these thresholds on the side here. So just play around with them. It will take a little bit of experimentation. As you can see, I just increased the hue threshold and now that green is mostly gone. And it did actually a better job than when I had the green channel selected. Cause you can see that on the sides here, the green is pretty much gone around my fingers too. You also wanna try previewing the whole video because sometimes there will be parts of the video that where the color is not removed. And in that case, you might wanna play around with the side threshold a little more. And one thing to note is that the frame rate will be decreased in this video as it says on the side here. But upon exporting, when you actually finish the video, it will be the normal speed. So just keep that in mind. Now this looks pretty good to me. There are some areas where the green is still in the video, but I think that's fine for what I'm trying to do. And if the color isn't what you expected, if it has a lot more flaws than you expected, you could try redoing the first clip with a different object. Or trying to match the side threshold a little more. Other things you can do in this editor are add text or image overlays or even subtitles. You can change the audio up here. And then when you're happy with how your video is looking, click export. After a few moments of loading, your video will be done. If you see a small watermark in the corner here, you can remove that for free just by signing into your Kapwing account. And then if you want to save the video to your device, just hit the download button over here. Thanks for watching this video. If it was helpful, please give it a like and make sure to subscribe to join our awesome community of modern creators. Let us know if you have any other questions, thoughts, or feedback in the comments below, and we'll see you in the next video.